Christ devotional, where our aim is to steward our minds well by prayerfully giving it over to Scripture and the Lordship of Jesus Christ, the hope, the goal, and the ongoing fight. It's going to be for us to love God with all of our minds, and for our minds not to be prisons but sanctuaries of praise. Our focus for today will be lean not to your own understanding. Lean not to your own understanding. And we'll pull from Psalm 73, verses 16 and 17, Proverbs 3, verses 5 and 6. Please join me, though, first in a word of prayer. Father God in heaven, thank you for this day. Thank you for your word. Thank you for Christ, your Savior, Mediator, Redeemer, and King. Thank you for your truth, for the gift of our minds. Help us to think well, that we may follow you gladly. In Jesus' name, amen. Psalm 73, verses 16 and 17, God's Word reads, "But when I thought how to understand this, it seemed to me a wearisome task. Until I went to the sanctuary of God, then I discerned therein." Proverbs 3, 5 and 6. "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make straight your paths." The Word of the Living God. Mentally drained, frustrated, worn out. Ever been there? I think we all have at some point. And this is where we meet Asaph, the author of Psalm 73. This psalm is Asaph's honest account from doubt to despair to a restored delight in God. But the whole psalm really illustrates for us the importance of rightly stewarding your mind and loving God with all of your mind by trusting in Him. See, Asaph in Psalm 73 explains how he was frustrated by the prosperity of the wicked. The fact that those who seem the most blessed by God are those who have no care for God at all. As he observed this and thought about it, he became heated with jealousy and envy. Comparison completely stole his joy and his peace of mind. He said things like, "The wicked, those who don't follow God, those who don't care for God, they seem to have no pain until death. They eat the best food and always look great. They persist in pride. They get ahead through violence. Openly blaspheme God, but live a life of ease, free from worry, stress, and fear, and yet they're always increasing in riches." This was his observation of what he called the wicked. Then in Psalm 73, verses 13 through 14, Asaph ponders in his mind the question, "Why should I fight for purity and supremely seek God's face when the godless get all the blessings from God's hands?" He laments in his head and heart if it's really worth it to feel constant conviction of sin, while those who take no note of their sins seem to have the best joy and peace of mind. Have you ever noticed that in the world today and been frustrated by it, not knowing how to wrap your head around problems such as these, such as the wicked prospering in our world? Well, the rest of Psalm 73 makes plain that believers must consider, must think about the eternal end of the wicked, not just their temporary ease, so that we focus on the everlasting goodness of God toward us now and forever in Christ, because God is our treasure and it's our good to be near Him. But this shift in the psalm all hinges upon the verses that we begin with. Psalm 73, verses 16 and 17. Asaph says, "But when I thought how to understand this, the problem of the wicked prospering, seemed to him a wearisome task until he went into the sanctuary of God. Then he discerned their end. Asaph was wearing himself out, trying to, in his mind, understand all of this by himself. It wasn't until he sought the presence and the perspective of God that he began thinking soundly. When he was leaning to his own understanding, it brought him to the mental prison of despair, frustration, doubt, worry, and sin. Likewise, how much of our worry, fears, doubts, unbiblical thinking, and outright sinful thinking stems from us leaning to our own understanding. Our finite, limited, and sin-tainted understanding will only leave us weary. See through this text that everything changed for Asaph and will change for us when we repent of leaning to our own understanding and trust in the Lord with all of our hearts and minds. It was when Asaph set his mind on things above, drawing near to God in prayer, considering the wicked from God's perspective, that he seen the superficial nature of the sinner's success and the fleeting nature of their existence. It was when he set his eyes upon God that he took his eyes off of people and fixed his eyes on all the goodness that is in God. He seen that he was behaving foolishly and thinking ignorantly, but he also seen and considered that God is with him, as he's with us, guiding our path. God will receive us to eternal glory, and God is our greatest treasure. He's our strength. He's our satisfaction, not the material prosperity of wicked people. Loving God with all of our mind necessitates trusting in God rather than leaning to our own understanding. Friends, indeed, we live in a fallen world, but it remains our Father's world. And as His image bearers, as His children in Christ, we're wired as revelation receivers. In other words, we're not meant to create our own worldviews, and we're not meant to see the world through